नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम टू YCB लेवल 1 200 आवर्स योगा टीचर्स ट्रेनिंग विद आयुष्मान योग। माय नेम इज निधि एंड आई एम गोइंग टू बी योर कंपेनियन इन दिस जर्नी। लेट्स बिगिन। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट मिताहार एंड युक्ताहार। सो मिताहार, मित मीन्स मॉडरेट, आहार मीन्स डाइट। सो द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ मिताहार और मॉडरेट डाइट इज मेंशनड इन हठ योग प्रतीपिका विच इज रिटन बाय स्वात्माराम सूरी। So Sage Swatmaram explains Mitahara as an agreeable food which should be eaten as an offering to Lord Shiva, leaving 1/4 of the stomach empty. Right? So the shloka goes like this: Susnigdham Madhuram Aharash Chaturthansh Vivarjitaha. Susnigdham, lubricating or rich in natural oil. Madhur, naturally sweet. Ahar food. चतुर्थांश 1/4 विवर्जितः लीविंग एम्प्टी। भुज्यते शिव संप्रीत्य, भुज्यते शुड बी ईटन शिव संप्रीत्य एज इन ऑफरिंग टू प्लीज शिवा। मिताहार स उच्यते, सच फूड इज कॉल्ड एज मिताहार। सो टू पुट टुगेदर, द फूड शुड बी रिच इन नेचुरल ऑयल, शुड नॉट बी ड्राई, शुड बी नेचुरली स्वीट एंड अग्रीएबल, something which we like to eat and not forced to eat. And food should always be eaten as in prasadam, as an offering, leaving 1/4 of the stomach empty, right? So he says that food should always be taken as an offering, right? As a prasadam, as a sacred offering, right? You will notice that in many Asian culture, people do not talk when they eat. Right, the full attention is paid on to the food, the process of eating, the chewing, to every taste present on the plate. Right, the concept that food should be chewed at least 32 times because digestion start to happen from the mouth. Right, now chewing the food that many times is not possible if we are talking or if we are busy on the phone. Right, so the idea of considering the food as a sacred offering, so that when you take in the food, you pay full attention to it. Try experiencing this by yourself, right? Try eating in silence. No conversation, no phones, just you and the food and see what happens. Right? Then the next thing which he says is that food should be eaten as an offering to please Shiva. Now, this can be understood in terms of not eating for the sense gratification, but to eat in order to sustain the vehicle of the self, the body, right? As the popular saying goes, that eat to live, not live to eat, right? Then he talks about prescribed food and the prohibited food. Right? So these are the dietary guidelines for Hatha yogis, right? Somebody who follows every principle of Hatha sadhana. So first, the prohibited food or the apathya bhojan. So he says, katu amla tikshna lavan ushna harit sa. Katu means bitter. Amla, sour or acidic. Tikshna, pungent. Lavan, saltish. Ushna, hot. Harit shak, green vegetables apart from the ones which are prescribed. Sauvir, fermented. Tail, oily. Til, mixed with sesame seeds. Sarsapa, mustard seed. Madhya, intoxicating liquors. Matsayan, fish. Ajadimas, the meat of goat, etc. Dadhi, curd. Takra, buttermilk. Kulattham, horse gram. Kaul, jujuberry. Pindayak, oil cake. Hingu, asafetida. Lassun, garlic. Apathya mahua, should not be eaten. Then the prescribed food or pathya bhojan. Gaudhum, shali, yav, sashtik, shobhana, annam. So, gaudhum, wheat. Shali, rice. Yava, barley, or all of them belonging to the category of grain that ripens in 60 days. Sashtika, shobhana, annam. Then kshir means milk. Ajya, clarified butter or ghee. Khanda, crystallized sugar. Navneet, butter. Sita, white sugar. Madhuni, honey. Shunthi, dry ginger. Patolak, faladika, panchashakam. So the panchashak or the five green vegetables which are prescribed are patolak phal, kalsak, vastak, himlochika and balsak. These are the five green vegetables which are mentioned under the prescribed food or pathya bhojan. And these five vegetables, the name of these are not mentioned in Hatha Yoga Pradipika. The names are mentioned in Ghiranda Sahita. Then mudgadhi, moong. Divyam udakam, rain water. These are considered as the most conducive food for the yoga sadhak. Then he talks about the nourishing and the detrimental form of the food. So he says, bhojanam ahitam vidyat. Bhojanam means food. Ahitam, detrimental. Vidyat, it becomes detrimental when punarasya ushni kritam. Punarasya again. Ushni kritam, heating. Right? Reheating of the food. Ruksham, dry food. Atilavaram, amlayuktam. Kadasan, sakotkatam, varjayam. Atilavaram, excessive, salty. Amla, acidic. Kadasan, stale. Sakotkatam, too many mixed vegetables. Such foods are forbidden or detrimental for the yoga sadhak. So to put together, food which is reheated or dry or excessively salty or acidic or stale or there are too many mixed vegetables is forbidden for the yoga sadhak. Then he talks about the nourishing form of the food. He says, pushtam sumadhuram snigdham gavyam dhatu proportion. Pushtam, nourishing. Sumadhuram, naturally sweet. Snigdham, rich in natural oil. Gavyam, mixed with milk. Dhatu proportionam. Dhatu are seven constituents of the body. So the food should be nourishing for these dhatu. Manobhilashitam yogyam yogi bhojanam acharet. Manobhilashitam, something which is of the liking of the yogi. Yogyam, which is apt, suitable. Yogi bhojanam acharet. Such food is conducive for the yogis. So to put together, yogi should take food which is nourishing, rich in natural oil, naturally sweet, nourishing towards the dhatu, mixed with milk or ghee, something which is of the liking of the yogi, which is suitable and apt, that kind of food yogi should eat. Now the concept of yuktahara. Yukt means moderate, ahar means eat. So in Bhagavad Gita, a very popular shloka is mentioned about the benefit of moderate eating in terms of all the other moderations as well. We have read the shloka in unit 1, which is yuktahar viharasya yukt cheshtasya karmasu yukt swapnavabhodasya yogo bhavati dukkha. Yukt ahar viharasya. Somebody who is moderate in eating and viharasya, recreation. Yukt cheshtasya karmasu, somebody who is balanced in work. Yukt swapnavabodhasya, balanced in sleep, yogo bhavati dukkha, can mitigate all sorrows by the practicing of yoga. Right? So this is about the concept of mitahara and yuktahara. Go through the notes, stay consistent with your practice, and I will see you in the next lecture.